Hello students, now we are discussing the points related to unit number 6 of software testing quality assurance and automatic test data generation. So generally test data requires proper understanding of SRS document, SD document and source code of the software. We have discussed so many good number of techniques in the previous units for writing the test cases manually, but we need to know also how the automatic process of writing the test cases is the effectiveness of such automatically generated test cases for the test suite. It is really beneficial for the software testing. So automated test data generation, the definition is nothing but it is an activity that generates the test data automatically for the software under the test. The quality and effectiveness of is heavily dependent on the generated test data. The technical definition of automated test data generation is nothing but it is the assurance of software reliability partially depends on the testing. However, it is interesting to note that testing itself also needs to be reliable. Automating the testing process is a sound engineering approach that can make the testing efficient, cost effective, and reliable. Basically, the primary basic things of manual testing and automated testing is nothing but in manual testing, we need to write the test cases manually. Means we need to create the statement based on the inputs of the test related to SRS document, SD documents, and the source code of the software. But in automated test data generation, according to whatever we create the SRS and SD document, automated tool will be automatically write the test cases for the test suite. So we require some knowledge of software for generating the test data. All the techniques are based on either of the two or any combination of them. So manually write the test cases on the basis of selected techniques and execute them to see the correctness of the software. So how can we automate the process of generation of test cases or test data? It is nothing but the simplest way to generate the test data randomly, meaning without considering any internal structure or functionality of the software. In automated test data, the test data is generated, it is based on randomly, it is not created by statement one by one. Sometimes it is not considered the internal structure of the software product, or sometimes it not be considered the functionality of the software. So in however, this way may not be an appropriate way to generate the test data automatically. So which test adequacy factor is required for generating the test data under the automated test generation? So we may generate a large pool of test data randomly, or many use any specified techniques. This data is used as an input for testing the software. So we need to keep testing of software if we do not know when to stop the testing. So however, if we would come to know that enough testing is performed or not, this is only possible when we define the test adequacy criteria. So what are the test adequacy criteria given for that? So we need to, every segment of the source code should be executed at least once. Every branch of the source code should be executed at least once. Every condition should be tested at least once. Every path of source code should be executed at least once. Every dependent path of source code should be executed at least once. Every input requirement should be tested at least once. Every possible output of the program should be verified at least once. Every definition used path and definition clear path should be executed at least once. Means whatever we return in SRS document, SDD, and source for the software, we need to execute at least once every statement, whatever we mention in our document in our source code. So that is nothing but the test adequacy criteria for automated test data generation. So sometimes it is defined the criteria which is based on the two generation techniques, static and dynamic test data generation. So first we will see the static data generation. Static is nothing but the test data is generated either by statically evaluating the program or by actual execution of the program. This technique is this. The static evaluation are called static test data generation techniques. This technique do not require the execution of the program. So this is generally used the symbolic execution of the input variables or particular test adequacy criteria. The program is examined fully and its paths are traversed without executing the program. So static data generation technique may not be useful for program containing a large number of paths. And another is nothing but dynamic. The technique which has averaged the desired flow of the program. A function minimizes technique may be used to correct the input variables in order to select and execute the program. So what is the primary difference between static and dynamic? The dynamic is actual required execution of the program, but static does not require actual execution of the program. So static data generation is called as a deep binding and dynamic is called as a lead binding. So various approaches are also used to test data generation. The approaches to test data generation can be divided into two categories, that is nothing but static and dynamic data generation. One is does not require the execution of the program, that is called as static, and one technique is require execution of the program, that is called as a dynamic. We may add about any functional testing techniques, boundary value equivalence, partitioning, or structural testing techniques for the generation of test data. Program will execute automatically and test data will be generated on the basis of selected techniques. So the program execution will continue till the desired test adequacy criteria. So various approaches are used for that. That is nothing but random testing. So random testing generates the test data arbitrarily and executes the software using the data's inputs. Output of the software is compared with the expected output based on the inputs generated using random testing. It is the simplest and easiest way to generate the test data. For complex test adequacy criteria, it may not be an appropriate technique because it does not consider the internal structure and functionality of the source code. So in random testing, every statement of the source code may be sometimes not executed at least once. It is not going to the individual path for the execution. So it is not expensive and needs only a random number generated along with the software to make it functional. Then second is called as symbolic execution. So many techniques for test generation use a symbolic execution of the generation. The test data in which symbolic values are assigned to variables instead of actual values. The purpose is to generate an expression of terms of input variables. So symbolic execution is not the execution of program. It is just passing the values to a variables for generation of the expressions. But rather the process of assigning expressions to program variables as a path is connected to the code structure. So let us consider one example. The program is written here to calculate the roots of quadratic equation, the source code and the program graph. The selected path is nothing but 1, 7, 13, 25, 28, 32 for the purpose of symbolic execution. So this is the program for the calculating square root of the quadratic equation. Three variables are taken A, B, C, and D. Then entering the values for A, B, C. After taking that, compare the values between the range 0 to 100, and based on the flagged valued conditions, it will be checked the conditions valid 1, 0 and minus 1. If it is valid, then it will be calculated the equations. If it is not valid minus 1, then it is not a quadratic equation. Otherwise, we can provide input as a out of range. So first, we provide the input variables A, B, C, assign the values. Then in statement number 7 program line, we have selected a false branch to transfer control to the statement number 13. Hence, the first constraint of the input is this path is if value of A is less than or equal to 0 or greater than 100, or value of B is less than or equal to 0 or greater than or equal to 100, or Z is less than or equal to 0 or greater than 100, then valid is equal to 0. If path left statement execute 13 becomes false, then control transfer to the statement number 25, it is not equal to 1. And finally, the path also needs to statement number 25 to become false, so that control is transferred to statement number 28. Hence, the third constraint of system for this purpose is valid is not equal to minus 1. So, execute the selected path of all above mentioned. A constraint should be satisfied. Once of the test case travels the path 17 to 13, 25, 28, and 32 may be include the following inputs. Another set of the inputs. Another set of the inputs is x is minus 1, y 19, j 60. The same path is traversed with both of the test cases. Similarly, if we select x path, constraints of the systems are defined as same. Clearly, constraints of first and second contradictory meaning, infeasibility of path. So 17, 13, 25, 27, 31 is not a valid path. So the path is not feasible. So for the expected outcome, so this is the table generated as per the input given to the calculating quadratic equations. So first is not feasible solutions. We input values are not in range. Then second, third, there is no input is provided. Then 0, 50, 50, it is also not a quadratic equation. Then path is (17, 13, 25, 28 to 32) is a feasible solution. That is input 101, 50, 50. Then next, another one feasible three solutions related to input is 99, 0, 0, 50, 51, and 50, 50, 50. So these paths are is a feasible solutions for calculating the equal roots and real roots. So this is called as symbolic execution. Symbolic execution is nothing but we can provide the input values for the variables, whatever we define in a program. According to that, we can evaluate the expressions and what is our expected outcome that will be generated or not, we will check in the final remark. That is nothing but that input is feasible or not for actual calculating the expected outcome of our program. So that is called a symbolic execution concept. Then next concept related to test data generation is nothing but test data generation tools. So the various tools for generation of test data is still infancy, although some software industries have been using their own tools for the generation of test data. The output of such a tool is set of test data which include a sequence of inputs to the system. Some tools are also available that accept manually created and automatically generated predefined test sequence and execute the sequence without human prevention and supervision. Then few examples of such tools are Mercury, Green Radar Tool, Load Runner Tool, Rational Robot and Telelogic. The purpose of these tools is to execute already generated test cases and not to generate the test data automatically. The automatic test generation tools are different and designed for a specific purpose of test data generation. So some of the popular test generation tools are given in tables. So these are some automated test generation tools which is supported on the platform related to particular languages, and it is a description is nothing but PVEC is supported the platform Java and C++. It is test cases generated by applying branch storage and it is easy to use. Then GS data generator is ERP, CRM and data warehouse development. It creates industry specific data for acceptance testing. It is focuses on basically control and adherence repository. So these are the various tools are used in industries and organizations for software testing to generate the test data automatically. So software industries are focusing more quality product instead of increasing the functionality, because testing is one of the most powerful tool to improve the several quality of the software product based on the factors that is called reliability, security, correctness, and easy uses, maintainability. So test data is generated automatically, it will reduce the efforts of time and money, both budget. Although the process of automated test data generation is still in early stage, some reasonable success has been achieved by the industry. So further research is needed to develop effective tools and techniques. So special efforts is also required to increase the feasibility, user friendliness, and ease of these tools. Thank you so much.